Go to the Tools panel of Affinity Photo and select any of the shapes. Doesn't matter particularly which one. I'm going to go with the ellipse, but could be any other one. Then go up here and set the fill just there. Just set it to none. And I can just do that by clicking there. Just a little, that one, which is just a slash there. Just click that. And now the stroke, I'm going to go with green, but I'm just going to vary it as well. And you can modify the width as well. So let's just change that. And then just apply it. Hold down the shift so you get a nice circle. Don't have to, you could make ellipses, etc. And then got that one, and I'm going to apply another one. Hold again down the shift key. I can change the color, maybe go for red. And also I can change the width. I can just maybe reduce it down and so on and so on. So I'm going to create a couple of these there, maybe go for blue. Now with those, well, I don't want that. So there's blue. So I've got a nice design there. And I can add multiple ones. It can be any size. That's the great thing about vector designs. Now with that, what I can now do is I can merge these. So you've got these layers here. You don't have to have them selected. Doesn't matter. You can always go to a layer and merge visible. So they will all be merged. And what happens then? You get this layer with those there. You can remove these if you don't. But you can also just deselect them if that's what you want. What you can then do, go to the brushes panel. You can find that, like the layers, in view menu and studio. And with the brushes, just go over here to this side and new brush from selection. Obviously I've got that selected, so that's what's created. Nice little design there. Now I can apply the brush stroke. Let's just quickly I'm just going to remove those, probably just as easy. But you could keep them if you want, because you might create some variations. I'm not going to do that, but I'm just going to remove them. Now I'm just going to go to the brush tool, and there's over the brush tool here, and I can select that brush. And you can see the size there, 1571, and I can apply it just straight away, and you can see the design there. So you can rapidly, very quickly, fill your design with your brush stroke. But you can, of course, create some variations of that as well. So double click, you can duplicate it. So if you want to keep the original as well, perfectly reasonable as well. I'm using a pen, but you don't have to, you could use a mouse. And you can just change the size, maybe go for 400, something like that, a bit smaller, maybe change the spacing. You could also go to dynamics. There's the section there, dynamics. You've got general and dynamics, and you can change the size just so you can make a nice sort of, and you can see a design there, and you can always apply with it on screen. So you can actually, you don't have to get close that. You can always say, oh, you know what? I'd change that a bit better, make the spacing even more like that. And you can just vary it, and you can see the sort of design there you can create very quickly. However, what you can also do is you can go to dynamics. You can also use texture and sub brushes as well if you want to do that. And I can put some rotation jitter. Random, you can also tweak it there as well. You can also change the hue jitter. You can change these others as well if you want. So you can change that. Saturation and luminosity. So you've got that. Now what you can do, just apply it like that. And you can see as you apply it, just it changes obviously the pressure there. Now you can also have it random if you want. So it just changes random, perfectly reasonable as well. You just apply it over the, and they can all be set to pressure if you want, up to you. And you just apply it very quickly across the image. And you can, of course, vary it. So you say, just apply it just to create a very, very simple design like that. Or again, if you decide, you know what, the spacing's not great, maybe make it even closer. So you just apply it like that. So it's very, very rapid. And what happens, you'll see over here, it's created a layer. When you created this, this is on a layer. So you can actually just go to this layer and you can always deselect it. Say you don't want it, you can deselect it. But not only that, with that design there, of course, you can also now got a really nice sort of random filled color design. You can always go to filters and go say distort and deform. Just bring that panel up there. You've got similarity, you can set those. You add some pins there, just there. And you can just simply vary and distort this design and create some very unusual brushstroke designs. And of course, you can duplicate this design as well. So you don't have to just click apply, resize it and duplicate it. Hold down the Alt or Option key, create all kinds of different designs from that simple basic brushstroke. And you can repeat that again and again and so on. But you can do exactly the same with, say, another one. So let's just go and quickly there, maybe the, I don't know, donut tool would be reasonable, but say the star tool. So exactly the same as star tool, just create that. Now in this case, I'm not going to create multiple. I just wanted to show you, you can create multiple with multiple designs. So I've got this design here. And now just close this panel here. And go over here to the brushes. Once I've converted to pixel layer, because if I just, I'm going to quickly show you. So if I go over here now to the brushes, right click, and you'll see that new brush from selection is not available. Needs to be converted. So go to layer and go down to merge visible or rasterize, perfectly reasonable, but merge visible, and it's turned into a pixel layer. That's the key thing. So pixel layer, now you can go to the brushes. So there's brushes there, right click, and new brush from selection. So you'll just get a very basic star. And again, if you want, you can remove that, keep it, whatever. Now, just going to quickly go over to the brush tool. I can use one of the other tools as well, perfectly reasonable as well, but I'm just going to use the paintbrush tool and just select that. And now you can see your star and you can just apply it like that. Now, it doesn't look very dramatic at the moment, but of course what you can do, exactly the same as before, you can double click that. You can duplicate as well. If you don't want to lose the original, you can always just go to duplicate. So you just duplicate that and now you can tweak from that. So you just change that, reduce the size. Now, unfortunately, there's no feature of changing the background color of this. So if you've got a very dark brush, it makes it very hard to see the brush. It'd be nice if you could right click and change the color, because black is not always going to be suitable for every single color scheme in this. So again, you can change the spacing. You can see you can make it very intense. Change the rotation. If you want to rotate it there, you can see that rotates. But you can also do exactly the same as before. Huge jitter, and you can see what happens. You get this nice color change there, saturation, luminosity, etc., and size. So again, you can vary that, and you can also vary rotation if you want it nicely. And again, change the spacing. So if you want it very close, close, and now apply it, and you get a lovely sort of furry brush design, which can be applied across the image very quickly to fill the design like that. Well, hope you found this of interest. Any questions, please let me know in the comments below. Always great to hear. I mean, how do you use brushes? Do you like this sort of approach to creating brushes? Do you find it very easy? Would you prefer different ways? I think personally, I would love to see an auto from a shape design, a brush design from a shape. That would be a brilliant feature. Unfortunately, that's not there. So there's additional steps, those sort of things. Please put in the comments below. Always appreciated. A like or dislike as well. Always great. Thank you much.